thought.
Does it seem loud enough to you?
Yes, it seems loud enough to me. Only if we could stop the rehearsal for just a second, then it would be okay.
You know, let me see how the Apostles' Creed sounds. Do you know that? I believe in God the Father Almighty.
If we,
Will you please see what you can say? I'll help you a little bit.
Okay.
All right.
I'll help you a little bit.
All right.
I believe.
In God the Father Almighty.
In God the Father Almighty.
Maker of heaven and earth.
Maker of heaven and earth. And, could you repeat that one word?
And in Jesus Christ. His only Son, our Lord.
And His only Son, our Lord.
Who was conceived by the Holy Ghost. Born of the Virgin Mary.
Virgin Mary.
Suffered under Pontius Pilate.
Could you repeat those?
Suffered. Under. Pontius Pilate. Was crucified, dead, and buried. He descended into hell.
Could you repeat that word again?
He descended. Into hell. The third day he rose again from the dead. Would you rather say the Lord's Prayer?
Yes.
All right, I'd like to hear that from back here, too.
Okay. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen.
Thank you.
Welcome. You're welcome.
Thank you. Wasn't there some nice little thing we were learning in Sunday school the other day? Was that the B-I-B-L-E?
We weren't learning any song.
You know that though, don't you?
Yeah.
The B-I-B-L-E. How does that go?
The B-I-B-L-E. Yes, that's the book for me. I stand alone on the Word of God. The B-I-B-L-E.
Tell me the stories of Jesus.
Tell me the stories of Jesus. I love to hear
things I would ask him.
Sing the way I take love.
Jesus wants me for a Sunday.
Yeah.
Let's see, how does that go? Please don't touch that, Chris.
Why, Dad?
No, don't. That light will come down. Sorry.
Jesus wants me for a sun beam to shine for him each day, in every way try to please him at home, at school, at class. Hey.
Send a message to your grandma and grandpa Paul, what would you tell them?
Well, I would tell them...
Go over closer to the microphone, I think. What would you tell them?
I would tell them that if they were here, and they were going back, I would go with them.
You'd like to go and visit them, huh?
Yes.
And see some of your cousins, too?
Yeah.
That would be nice, wouldn't it? Mm-hmm. What would you tell your cousins if you were going to go see them?
Well, I would know.
Would you tell them you'd certainly like to be able to play with them?
Yes. And I would tell them that I like them a lot.
That you like them a lot. I guess you do.
Would you like to sing some more?
No, I don't think I'll plan to sing anything. You know what I think?
What?
I think we ought to play this back and see what it sounds like, huh? Okay, Kenny boy, you want to play a little something for us?
All right, how about the trumpeter?
All right, let her go.
Thank you.
organ?
Ask Percy, why don't you suggest something?
Well, you just play some of the pieces you like to play there.
All right.
Rochester, and I wish that they'd come up to see us sometime.
Yeah. I know you'd sure like to be going out to see them, wouldn't you?
Yep.
Wish you could be going with me, Ken.
Me too. I should like to be riding the horses and pick those figs off the trees like you were always talking about.
Would you want to send any messages to any of your cousins? Your aunts and uncles out there?
Wait, which of my uncles plays trumpet?
Cecil, your uncle.
Cecil? Tell him to make a recording for me. Tell him to make a recording for me. I'd love to hear him play.
Let's see, I'm not sure that he plays the trumpet either. I know he plays the banjo and the ukulele.
Good.
Or the guitar, I guess.
Ask him if he's got any free pamphlets he'd like to send me.
I bet you'd like to be out there with your Uncle Harwood, too, and he visits the farm. Sometimes he takes David around with him, I imagine.
Yeah.
When they have their celebrations, he rides his horse in the parade.
Yeah, well, at least I can say this. Hi, Grandma and Grandpa.
All right, Kenny, let's record something else. What are you going to record this time?
All right, I think it's called The Thunder.
All right, you and Mommy are going to do it together, huh?
Yeah.
All right.
Ready? Thank you.
Want to hear it now?
Yeah.
Keep it down.
Oh, Jeff played it first.
You did?
Yeah.
How'd it sound?
Awful.
That's what I was thinking.
Sarah, do you want to hear your voice?
Yeah.
Do you say something?
Oh, no, I don't want to say something to hear it. I want to hear something that I said already.
Oh.
Mommy, you don't have to. Why don't you make a recording for
Laura
to take back?
No, Mother.
You don't mind if I...
No.
You don't mind having me with this, do you? No,
the two of you play.
Yeah, I called you.
Thank you. All right, David, now what are you going to play? Dixie, what's David going to play now?
Melody of Love.
Melody of Love. Okay, Dave, let's hear you play it. What's this you're going to play?
Man with the Banjo.
All right, the Man with the Banjo. Thank you. How many verses are there to that?
20.
20? Well, I got this going again now.
Well, we surely wish they were here to enjoy these days with us, these lovely trips that we've had together.
Well, we sure have been getting around the country, and for me, seeing a lot of people that I hadn't seen before.
Well, we've seen a lot of people, too, that we hadn't seen for a long time. We enjoyed our day at Solvang and our days here at Santa Maria so much.
We're looking forward to our trip in Oregon, where we will see Annabelle and Cecil and Pam and Bobby.
And then we're looking forward to a trip east again. See our dear ones there.
I hope that won't be too long.
I hope
so far away.
We surely love them and want to see them before they grow up too far. Mm-hmm.
And you know, Kenny and Kristi, we just certainly love to hear you play and sing and talk. We just love to hear your voice. And we want to tell Mama, too, how happy we are that she let Daddy come out here to see us. We know she's lonesome and waiting for him. And we let him go when his time comes.
We send the word to Grandma, too. We hope she was fine all the time that Daddy was away.
I imagine she's keeping pretty busy.
I guess she did. And
right now, let's see, this is
Wednesday.
Kenny's getting...
Let's wait. It's 11 o'clock.
11 o'clock right there. Well, they're in bed now, but...
Kenny's snoring nice and loud, I'll bet.
Can you hear him?
You can almost hear him. Well, we see by Willard's church paper that Grandma Jubert is keeping pretty busy in the church, too, so... I guess she's happy in there, work there.
Kenny's getting ready for camp right now.
Oh, yes.
And Friday, or Saturday morning, I guess, he goes up to camp. Goes in a bus, it'll be about a 250-mile ride. So he'll be having a great time up there in the woods, doing some hiking and camping out.
Just cousin Bill too, Rawson, had a good trip on his camp. He certainly enjoyed it. It was nice and brown when he got back. I suppose Kenny will be nice and brown when he gets back.
He sure will.
Where is he going up to? Whether it's water or up in the trees?
There'll be both water and woods up there. Camp Massawippi is near Tupper Lake. Mm-hmm. And he'll get in some good swimming and some good hiking.
Tupper Lake, did we come by Tupper Lake?
Yeah, you came right by Tupper Lake.
In fact,
you came right by Camp Massawippi.
Oh.
On your way from Watertown.
What is the name of that place we stayed overnight at when we came through Rochester? Do you remember? Webster, do you remember?
Oh,
Webster?
Yes.
Do you know Webster?
Yeah, well, it's out at the end of 5 Mile Line Road and on 401.
Oh.
104.
Well, that's where we stayed overnight when we went out there last time.
Mm-hmm.
We drove out.
You remember the place?
It was the first place we came to. Up on the side of the hill.
And we drove off the highway.
After you'd gone through Rochester?
Yes.
Yeah.
Uh-huh. Of course, Webster's only a matter of 3 or 4 miles out of Rochester.
Had we had good sense, we stayed the other side of Rochester and not gone through at 5 o'clock at night.
Uh-huh.
bumper to bumper.
We went through there bumper to bumper, bumper.
Oh yeah, well that
all the way through.
Kodak Park was just getting out eastward.
That all the main streets there, they didn't depend on the lights. They had a policeman there to direct traffic.
Yeah.
Every main. How they ever got them through, I don't know.
The only place I think we went through at 5 o'clock.
Well, they employ 35,000 people there, so.
Mm-hmm. You mean at the one plant?
Well, not at the Eastman plants right in around there. So that you've got that many people dispersing in all directions at the same time.
Well, you certainly realize that if we went through town and saw the traffic there. It's terrific. I should think they would reroute that main traffic line there around town somewhere.
Well, they'll have an overpass. Over that sometime, yeah. Well, we better switch this
night.
Off. Yeah.
Good nearly good morning.
Now we're recording. There we are.
How can you tell?
Well, because now I can hear it coming back.
Huh? You talk and let me hear.
All right. Can you hear that now?
Yeah.
Sure. And that's going on the tape. How don't you want to send a message back to Dixie and David?
Dixie and David.
Hello,
Kristi and Kenny.
Hello, Kristi and Kenny. This is Bobby from Oregon.
What would you like to tell them?
Come out and see me.
Get up, boy.
I'll take you fishing out here in Oregon.
Yeah. Take him out there on the jetty.
I'll take you out on the jetty.
Tell him we have a little boat and motor. You'll take him out.
I have my little boat and motor. I'll take you out in that.
What's this we're gonna sing?
Riding down the canyon.
Riding down the canyon, huh? Okay.
What's
this gonna be now?
Preacher and the Bear.
The Preacher and the Bear. Okay.
Down in Tennessee. Yeah. Well, the preacher went out hunting, was on one Sunday morning. Well, we know it was against his religion, but he took his gun along. Well, he shot himself some very fine quail, one big mealy hare. Was a sight to see. Well, the preacher got so excited, he climbed a simmon tree. Well, the bear sat down upon the ground, and the preacher climbed down on them. Bear his eyes to the God in the skies, and these words he said to him. Oh, Lord, didn't you deliver them from the lion's den? Also, deliver Jonah from the belly of the whale, and then three Hebrew children from the fiery furnace, where the good book to declare. Well, Lordy, Lordy, if you can't help me, for goodness sakes, don't help that bear.
That's an awful high.
That was good. Was that too high?
Pretty high.
Can you play it faster, my chance?
Yeah, well, we can play it fast.
Wait, is it on?
Now we're on, yeah.
Is it on now?
Mm-hmm.
Well, this is part of the guitar boogie.
What's this you're going to sing now, Bobby?
Who at my door is standing.
Who at my door is standing? Good.
Who at my door is standing, patiently drawing near, entrance within. The voice I hear. Softly the shadows are falling. Open the door for me. If thou would heed my calling, I would abide.
We can't get ourselves in fits tonight.
Do you want to hear that one now?
Mm-hmm.
All right. Do you sing with him, Annie? You know.
I encourage them, though.
Yes, I like to hear them sing.
Let me hear you sing with.
Sing.
Let it be.
That's
a good song.
Annie and I used to sing duets all the time, didn't we?
That's a good one of the three of us. I don't know all of us sing that one.
What's that?
But not strong.
Right there, Bobby, on the floor.
Oh, my Lordy, Lordy. Oh, my Lordy, Lordy. That's a bass. You gotta have a bass in that.
You can't sing in both, huh?
You sing bass and all sing tenor, and they'll never know the tune.
Is that playing back now?
No, it's recording.
Are you kidding?
Huh?
No.
They wanted to face on
me. I'll never be able to face your band.
It's about at the end of the text. Uh-huh. We better at least tell them hello.
They don't want to speak to me.
They'll love you.
I didn't know it was recording. I thought he was turning it back to play back for Bobby.
Oh, they don't know.